This is London. You will now hear a statement by the Prime Minister.
I am speaking to you from the Cabinet Room at 10 Downing Street. This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note. I have to tell you now. This country is at war with Germany.
My father asked me if I was truly ready to go to war. He told me that the good soldier kills without thinking of his enemy as a human being. In the moment he sees him as a fellow man, he's no longer a good soldier. And I was a good soldier. God help me. Within each of us lie the seeds of an undefined greatness. We are the fathers of our own future. That future must be chosen, nurtured, guided. It must be driven with conviction. Lest our lesser nature has led it stray into shadow. Using weapons we had never dreamed of. But death is death, no matter where you are. And suffering is the same in every language.
Vorwärts! Vorsicht! Feindlicher Panzer! 12 Uhr!
Formation halten!
Feuer auf das Ziel eröffnen! Kopf!
Technology moved faster than you could think how to use it. Yours, theirs, it didn't matter. This war would prove that from ocean bed to mountaintop, the greatest killing machine is man.
Et voilà.
Total war brought death home. It wasn't just about the soldiers on the front. This time, the crosshairs found the workers on the assembly line. They found the commuters on the train. And they found the children in the schools.
Geschwader! Ich sehe den Bomber!
Formation halten, Geschwader!
Infantry, volunteers, conscripts, them and us. It didn't matter where the danger came from. The threat of death unified everyone. Victory meant staying alive. Man's unworthiest creation. What led it back to us? Does a hidden hand guide it? Birthing us in violence and blood? Ending us in fear? Alone? Until you've pulled the trigger on an enemy, you're not ready for war. You're only ready to die.
We have no world without them, and there is no other world.